We are in Dhammapada, stanza number 149. Jaravagga. Yani mani apattani alapuneva sarade kapotakani attini thani disvana karati. Meaning of this stanza is, like ground cast away in autumn are these dowherd bones. What pleasure is there in looking at them? This stanza delivered by the Buddha because there was a group of monks who got advice to practice meditation from the Buddha, and they went away to practice meditation. While they were practicing, they thought themselves they already attained enlightenment. And then they decided, okay, now we already enlightened, better to go to see Buddha to pass this message to the Buddha. So, when Buddha was dwelling in Jetavana monastery, they came to see the Buddha. On the way to monastery, the Buddha knew they are coming to see the Buddha. Before enter the temple permissions, Buddha sent a message with the Venerable Ananda to them. Before getting to temple, better to go the cemetery which is next to the temple. That is the advice given by the Buddha. That was the advice given by the Buddha. So that monks did not request any reasons why we are going there. Without inquiring any reason, they directly went to the cemetery. While they were in cemetery, looking at here and there, they had met different kind of dead bodies and dead bodies natures. Some bodies already had remained with the bone, somebody had some flesh, somebody just like blood. In this manner, different kind of seeing different kind of dead bodies, they get fear and worries. Those thoughts, they are recognizing those thoughts, they recognize, oh, we are not attained enlightenment yet. That's why we have these thoughts with us. Suddenly the Buddha appeared in front of them. And then Buddha gave this stanza for them to think about themselves. Like grounds cast away in autumn are these dowherd's bones. What pleasure is there in looking at them? This is the advice given by the Buddha to Buddha for them. Then thinking Buddha's advice, they were able to attain enlightenment. So in this stanza, there are few words that we should keep in our mind. We should analyze. We should research, re-research. What are those? Alapuni iva. Alapuni iva means there is a simile. In this simile, explain with the nature of the environments, with the influence of the environments, the bone had been changing into different colors. Those days in India, they did not buried or they did not do anything, their dead bodies, they just throw it in that canal ground. And also, they wrap up some cloth they took into the cemetery and keep there. They did not bury those dead bodies those days. So, with the influence of the environment, because of rain and sometimes wind, and also some other influence, those dead bodies had been changing in different colors and different ways. As you know, there are few ways that we can see our dead bodies. The first stage you can see blotted. And second stage you can see discolored. Third stage you can see festering. Fourth stage you can see dissected. And fifth stage you can see gnawed to pieces. And in sixth you can see scattered in pieces. And seventh you can see mutilated and scattered in pieces. Eighth, bloody. Ninth, warm, inspected. Ten, skeleton. All these stages are mentioned in Satipatthana Sutta, Mahasatipatthana Sutta. This happened into our body, dead body. All these are happening with the influence of the environment, particularly air, sun, and sometimes might be some animals, likewise fox, might be tigers or lions, whatever, who eat flesh. They come and do those kind of things. Then with the help of this environment, these changes would be with that dead body. It's happening. So the Buddha asking from this monk, Alapuni, already had been changing this dead body into different ways. Kapotakani, the colors like between ash and white color, the bones or the remain parts, some of the body parts. And Attini, completely you can see with somebody's completely turned into a skeleton. No any flesh, nothing. Seeing all these stages, is there any? Tani diswana kariti. Is there any reasons to increase your lust? Is there any reason to increase your lust? This is the questions raised by the Buddha to that monks. Because those monks, some of monks, seen some dead bodies, the pressed dead bodies, increase some kind of thoughts, likewise, oh, this is kind of beautiful, this is kind of ugly. Somehow, defilements was there in their mind. So, seeing this nature, realizing this nature, the Buddha advised them to think about these stages of the body. Now you can see the final advice given by the Buddha to that monk. Tani diswana karati. Why? You increase lust to this body. This is the nature of the body. This is the nature of the body. But that's not enough. Even though it's go beyond that. Skeletons also not remain forever. Remain in some years and then later that skeletons also connecting, turning into four elements. According to the Abhidhamma, eight elements. That elements connecting with others and then finally you can see in different ways, different elements. Likewise, the body, finally it will connect with the soil. Then you can see the difference. As you know, you can take oil from earth. That oil used to be, I mean, oil generated by millions years all dead bodies. This is kind of explanation that we have as a general idea. So this is the nature of the body. This body ready to die, I mean, always is dying, but no one can recognize because of lack of our wisdom. We are not able to see that changes, that nature. So we are thinking, we are existing, we are living. Why? We are not able to see these changes. Each and every moment it happens, the changes are there. Every moment, as you know, according to Abhidhamma, 17 nanoseconds, you can exist. This body can exist. But the mind can exist only 1 nanosecond. 17 nanoseconds, who can think even that much speed? Who can think? Who can recognize that speed changes? No one can recognize because our mind is weak. Mind always full of defilements. Therefore, mind is not able to follow that activities. What is happening there? Then we think we are living. We are living. Things are existing. No one born to this world like us right now. We are adults now. No one born to this world like us now. What happened there? So many changes were there. We started this life as an unseen thing through our eyes. So sometimes you can see using some kind of electronic hegematic. Otherwise, even no one can recognize the body that we have today. But this body now gaining weight and gaining height, we have different phase, different stages. But we know what is happening each and every moment with this body, changing, 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 changing. The Buddha used the word for this, jara, jara. Jara means decaying. What is decaying? Is there something existing to decay? Nothing existing. In this process, you can see decay. Nothing existing. But in this process, you can see with the help of all these things, something happening to the body. Otherwise, nothing existing in this world. This is kind of very deep level things, but we have to use this physical changes, even using long time to see your pictures and see your other knowledge and experiences. We can get some ideas. For example, take your pictures. When you were 1 year old, 2 year old, 3 year old, 5 year old, 10 years old, and 15 years old, 20 years old, 25 years old, 30 years old. In this manner, you can line up some pictures. And then at the end, keep the picture that you took recently. And think about the pictures that you have in first, the pictures that you have in last. What are the process between these two pictures? It is not easy to recognize, but you have some kind of thoughts. Oh, this is me. This is me. This is me. And then sometimes perhaps might be when you are 10 years old, you can memorize the time that you got this picture. Where you got this picture, you can memorize. Just the memory is there. With the help of all these memories and information, then finally you can come to conclusion, this was me. This is me now. This was me. These were my pictures. these were my appearances, physical appearances. You can come to conclusion, but that is because of your ignorance. Actually, the person who is in that first picture is not the person who is in second picture. It has been changing. There are so many changes, but if you are full of cloud, ignorance, so you are not able to see the process, what happened there. The process is unseen through our eyes. This eyes powerful, not powerful enough to see the process there. But at the end, this happened into our body. What is happening there? Changing colors of this body and becoming skeleton. And even you can't see your flesh, you can't see your blood, veins, any of the body parts, you can't see through that skeleton. Everything had been changing, connecting with elements. And that element's ready to create something else. The elements create something else. When you die, the body put on earth, if someone put there a tree, a plant of tree, then when tree is growing with the help of that body, turning that body will turn to food for that tree, the plant. So after that, you can see there a tree, not a body. It had been changing completely. So seeing this nature of your body, Tani Diswanakarati, seeing all this process of your dead body, but in here particularly Buddha addressed to that monks, to see these dead bodies, seeing these dead bodies, what is the reasons to have lust with you about this body? Because this is also a process. This is also not reality, it is also process. This is not something existing, it is a process. So in this process, what is the reasons to have lust? Reason is ignorance. You're not able to see the reality. That's why you have lust there. So the Buddha giving us some examples, some similes to think ourselves, the nature of this body, the nature of this body. But seeing this nature, increasing our insight, what we should do? We should protect our mind. We should protect our mind. From what? From defilements. From defilements. And also to manage our life. Managing life means, I can use one word for that. Managing life means less drama, more dhamma. Less drama, more dhamma. This is the managing life. As we know, we are not enlightened beings. Therefore, we are living with all the defilements. So, if you are living under defilements, we don't know when, how our mind driving into wrong direction. We have to be very careful. Being a careful person, you're ready to drive into, always drive into right directions. And perhaps because of our mundane nature, if there is some situations with you, or you are going in wrong direction, seeing that right away, developing your energy, try to be the correct, get into right path, right directions. This is the meaning of managing life. So, through this stanza and this story, as a mundane person, to manage our life, we have to get these teachings. This is the nature of the world, but no one is experiencing it. particularly present day, we are not able to see this kind of dead bodies. Because in the world now, we don't have this process. But until that means until die, when the body is existing with the mental connection, with the mental formation, you can see how many changes, what kind of changes happen in there. So many changes happening in our life, we can see that. Seeing that, you can assume this would be with our body after departing the mind from the body, the physical form. It should be. Assume you can. Assuming we have to use that opportunity to develop our insight, develop our wisdom. Why? To manage life. Not to drive into wrong directions, keep in right directions, and using this wonderful opportunity to gain insight. Wonderful opportunities mean, dear friends, we don't know how much we have opportunity to get rebirth as human beings. We don't know that. There's no guarantee. If you attain sotapanna, then you can guarantee yourself, no, I might never go any low level realm. You have guarantee for that. But who are not in that stage, none of us have that guarantee. None of us have that guarantee. Therefore, we have to use this opportunity, being human beings, and also taking opportunity to listen to Dhamma, to read Dhamma, to study Dhamma, the teachings of the Buddha. We have to use this opportunity to reduce unwholesome thoughts, increase in wholesomeness, increase in wholesomeness. This is the main purpose of this stanza. Not only this stanza, all teachings of the Buddha, this is the main purpose. All these teachings delivered by the Buddha to mundane people. Mundane are living with defilements. Then first thing that we should do as a mundane, we should uplift our mind. Uplift our minds means we should try to gain the wisdom. There is no any solution, any duty for us to without gaining humanity, without gaining our mind. Gaining mind is the main purpose of our life. We born to this human world for what? To gain mind, gain humanity. Gaining mind and gaining humanity, these are not two different, same thing. But unfortunately, divided into few groups in this world, and even though we human beings are dividing because of our religion, because of our ethnicity, and because of some other reasons, we try to divide. We want to separate. Why? Because of with the influence of ignorance. This happening because of ignorance. This body nature, the dead body nature, is unique for all living beings, not just human beings, who has the body, physical body. They all had been passing these stages. There are 10 stages. All these 10 ages are 10 stages are unique for all living beings who have this physical form. So using that opportunity, now we don't have that opportunity in our environment. But anyway, we can assume through our experiences, and assuming our through our experiences, we should uplift our mind with qualities, our mind with loving kindness thoughts, compassionate thoughts, sympathetic joy and equanimity. This is the way how we can gain our humanity, human qualities. So, keeping this in our mind, let us practice this Dhamma and see reality, develop your energy, develop your effort for what? To protect and develop your wholesomeness and to decrease your unwholesomeness. Decrease your unwholesomeness. I think that would be enough for today. Now we can use this opportunity to share merits with the departed relatives and family members and pets who departed name of us. By the power of these merits and metta thoughts, may they all be well, happy and peaceful. Having that aspiration, say sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Whoever is affected COVID-19 and any other sicknesses, by the power of these merits and metta thoughts, may they all be well, happy and peaceful. May they be able to get rid of their pain and suffering. Having that aspiration, say sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. May you all be well, happy and peaceful. All your wishes come true by the power of these merits and metta thoughts. May we all be well, happy, and may we all be able to attain ultimate bliss of Nibbana. Having that aspiration, say sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. By means of these meritorious deeds, may I never join with the foolish. May I join always with the wise until the time attain Nibbana. May the suffering be free from suffering. May the fear struck be free from fear. May the grieving be free from grief. So too may all beings be. From the highest realms of existence to the lowest, may all beings arisen in these realms, with form and without form, with perception and without perception, be released from all suffering and attain to perfect peace. Excellent, excellent, excellent.
Thank you, Bhante. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.
Thank you. Thank you, Bhante.
Thank you.
Thank you.